There are many ways parenting schedules can work for a child. When you're making this difficult decision, probably one of the most important factors to keep in mind is, am I agreeing to something that I can and will follow through with? Being consistent and being reliable in your responsibility to the plan builds trust and security for your child. It's better to say, I'll be there once a month and to show up, than to say you'll be there for a weekly visit and disappoint your child. Children are heartbroken when they prepare and expect to spend time with a parent who doesn't show. I once spoke with a middle-aged gentleman who said he'd grown up in the South with his mother, brothers, and sisters. They grew up in a rural area and were quite poor. His father lived in another state and had few resources in which to spend time with his children. What this father did do, however, was he made sure that he saw his son once a year on his birthday. As an adult, this man looked back and said he never doubted his father's love. It was because he could count on the consistency of those annual visits. When a parent is not consistent, this is difficult to explain to a child. I once knew a young lady. She was about 8 at the time of this story. Her father lived in the same town and could have seen her regularly for weekly visits. For whatever the reasons were, he chose not to. When I asked this little girl, "How come you think Daddy doesn't come?" she thought about it for a minute and responded, "Well, I guess I have a very big heart and I'm really nice to people, but maybe my daddy has a small heart. He's not able to be as nice." This is a good example of a child who did not blame herself. However, it's an unusual example. Most of the time, children hold themselves responsible for their parents' shortcomings. They blame themselves and they think of themselves as unworthy or unlovable when they're disappointed by a parent. This can be a foundation for problems that you do not want your children to experience. So please remember the importance of your consistency. If you're the parent who has to deal with the child's disappointment after another parent hasn't shown up, the one thing that you can do is to ask yourself, am I doing everything possible to make the other parent feel welcome in my child's life? Am I doing everything possible to make what are often difficult transitions between one parent's home and the other? If you are the parent seeing the disappointment in your child when the other parent has failed, please ask yourself, am I doing everything that I can possibly do to make the other parent feel welcome in my child's life? Am I doing everything that I can possibly do to make what can be difficult transitions comfortable for everyone? Often, when I'll ask a parent who doesn't show for visits, why? Your children love you. Your children need you. Why are you not there? They will respond, it's too uncomfortable. It's too hard on everyone. We always have disagreements or arguments. Often, if I'll ask an absent parent, why aren't you there? Your children love you and they need you. They will respond with something to the effect of, it's too hard, it's too difficult. We often get into arguments or disagreements. It seems like it's easier on everyone if I don't go. As the parent who's caring fully for the children and who sees their disappointment, ask yourself if there's anything that you can do to remedy that situation.